I'm Steve Frangic, fighting from Orangeville, Ontario. This is my 14th professional fight. My first pro fight, yeah, I was lucky enough to have it in front of my hometown fans and everyone, so it was great. Fight went well. I won a second round TKO over Horace Hunter, and couldn't have been happier with it. You know, I've never been a huge one-punch knockout artist or anything, but I think I put my punches together pretty well with decent power, and wear guys down. I keep hitting them, and eventually they can't stand it anymore. You know, growing up, I was kind of putting on a few pounds, and my family owned a family restaurant, so I was eating a lot of junk, and so I joined the gym just to kind of get in shape, and then stuck with it from there. My coach, Brian Mackey, started me from the first day in the gym, you know, and he's taught me everything I know, and we've been together since, every day working, and he's the best man for the job. I like he has the experience. He's been there. He's been in the ring with like best pro fighters in the world, and so I can learn like a lot of experience from him. Also, you know, we have a good chemistry in the ring. I can listen for him. He tells me exactly what to do, and I just execute. Yeah, I had a 140 amateur fights.
Yeah,
I was on the national team for 2 years, and then once we went pro, I found the pro style was more suitable for my boxing style. A lot of guys were outpointing me in the amateur, especially in the international system. So pro was the way to go, and done pretty well so far. I think I'd like to kind of model myself after Miguel Cotto's style, or early Miguel Cotto. He was always a little bit of pressure, always walking guys down, banging the body hard, and wearing guys down towards the end of the fights, scoring big knockouts. I didn't really know Cotto. He wasn't very big when I started boxing, but when I did start, I was a big De La Hoya fan, Tito Trinidad, guys like that, Arturo Gatti and Mickey Ward. Those fights were big when I just started boxing, so they kind of stayed with me.
Yeah.
None of my family was ever involved until I got started. And once I joined the gym and started having a bit of success, my brother joined. So now it's all our family talks about, just boxing all the time. No, it was great. Dropped down in weight, which was a bit difficult, but it got the win. It was a good fight, and to hold the title, it's just like such an honor. Went 10 rounds, went the distance, and the opponent, Gary Kopis, was there every step of the way. He made it a really tough fight. And I had to dig down deep in the last few rounds to secure the win. I had a lot of my fights at West in Edmonton, simply because we weren't getting fights locally, so it was just a business decision. And you know, I'm thankful they put me on out there, and I had a great time. But I'm glad to be back here, and look forward to putting on a show for everyone locally. Yeah, absolutely. I'm very excited. Huge main event. And I'm just so fortunate to be the co-main event on such a good card, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring, fighting tonight out of the blue corner, Alvaro La Cobra Gaona.
Alvaro Gaona, known as La Cobra, 12-4 with 8 KOs at 29 years of age. This Mexican fighter stands 6 foot tall, so you know he's got knockout power in his 12 wins. 8 of them come via the knockout. By the nickname La Cobra, so you know that he's going to be one of those sneaky quick guys.
And now let's welcome to the ring, fighting tonight out of the red corner, Silent Steve Frangic.
by the nickname Silent Steve, but it's not because he's not a man of, he is a man of few words, but that's not the reason. It's because he's silent and deadly in the ring.
Yeah, I've known Franzik for a while too. He's a calm, cool, collected guy, nice guy, but the boy can fight.
Yeah, he likes to say that his fists do the talking, right?
Yeah, and now he's a full 3 inches taller than his opponent here tonight. That means arm length will come into it as well.
Oh, yeah.
And it's a really nice story, too. You know, a pudgy kid goes into the gym looking to shed some pounds. His dad always knew, you know, that he'd be a great athlete. And he pretty much is a gym rat, doesn't want to leave. And Coach Brian Mackey has to, like, literally kick him out of the gym sometimes because he is that dedicated.
And it's nice to learn from a guy like Brian Mackey, who's been around the fight game pretty much for the last 20 years.
Mackey's a great guy, yeah. I've helped Mackey get ready for some fights in the past and just have a ton of fun working with the guy.
And a guy that knows what it's like to be on a big stage as well.
He's oh, yeah.
He's in Vegas.
Oh, yeah, he's been in some great fights.
You know, Gaona, though, we can't exactly count him out just yet. He has a lot of accolades to his credit. In 2010, he won the vacant WBC figure box middleweight title. In 2012, he won the WBC Mundo Hispano middleweight title. So he's got a few accolades to his name. We can't exactly just hand it to Franzik just yet.
No, we're not doing that, that's for sure. Franzik at 12-0-1 draw. Really comes in with a nice record, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for our co-main event. It is scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing in the light heavyweight division. Brought to you by United Boxing Promotions in association with Title Fight Promotions and their great sponsor, Tire Discounter. Our three judges scoring on a 10-point must system will be Kelly Zolmierczyk, Harry Davis, and Alan Davis. When the bell rings, our referee in charge, the third man in the ring, will be Rocky Zolmierczyk. Introducing to you first, fighting tonight out of the blue corner, he's wearing red with white and weighed in at 174.5 pounds. He brings a professional record of 12 wins, 4 defeats, with 8 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Reynosa, Tamaulipas, Mexico, presentando Alvaro La Cobra Gaona. And his opponent across the ring, fighting tonight out of the red corner, he's wearing orange with black and white and weighed in at 174 pounds. Hailing from Orangeville, Ontario, he is undefeated with 12 wins, 1 draw, with 7 of his 12 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Silent Steve Franzik.
Fighters, chief second. Okay, I went over the instructions and changes. I expect you to obey my commands. Touch up, come out banging.
There's the tail of the tape between these two fighters, and one of the things that you don't see on there that we will see during the fight is the reach advantage of Steve Franzik. Here we go, round number one of the scheduled 8 rounder. Gaona wearing the red trimmed in white, Franzik in the orange trimmed in black and white. Good body shot coming from Franzik. Boy, Gaona really holds his hands low.
And he's already being cornered this early in the fight, literally.
Up with the jab to get Krajicek backpedaling just a slight tad so he can come out of trouble. He hits on that left hook. Krajicek again going to the body, over the top to the head. Krajicek connects again. Now we're not really playing on the ropes. It's a dangerous game to be playing.
That comfort and confidence is coming from the fact that he's already controlling the ring, backing him down, and, you know, cutting the ring off really effectively.
Big looping left hand. Now a looping right coming from Gaona. Boy, he's missed with a couple of hooks by more than a few inches.
Yeah, you know, Gaona, he looks really awkward. He doesn't look very comfortable in there right now. I even see him turtling a little bit as shots are coming. Not looking too good for him right now, but it's only the first round.
Krajicek looking to put this one away in the first round with a good flurry. Then goes over the top, catches him with a left right on the butt.
It's a good hook. He didn't like it. He didn't like that.
Good straight left.